Alright, I'm going to challenge us.
What does early mean? Early means early. Early means first. Early means first. I love them that love me. And those who love me will seek me first. Will seek me early. That means get up early, and the first thing you do is seek the Lord. It means first.
Well, Pastor, you understand. You've got to get up, and you have the work, and you have the thing, and I got to do this. And as soon as I wake up, man, I hit the road running. And I'm like, okay, then set your alarm clock so we wake up a half hour earlier.
No.
Go to sleep a half hour earlier, and get up a half hour earlier. So that you seek the Lord first. For those who seek me early shall find me. Folks, that is a guarantee. And if there's anything that the world needs today, it's more of God. Say amen. It's more of God. If the church needs anything today, it's not more programs. How many times have I said this? Not insinuating anything negative about us. But the body of Christ doesn't need more programs. We need more God. The United States of America does not need more social programs. And the last thing the United States needs is core education. What the United States needs is more of God. Rather than core education, we need God education. We need holy and faith education once again. We need more of God. Seek me early, and ye shall find me. Now, folks, I don't want to pad my own pew, but I'm not just some crazed preacher shouting this. I'm an expert. I'm an expert in these things. We don't need core education. If you don't understand core education, you come and talk to me about it. What we need is God education. I'm not saying that we're going to start quoting the Ten Commandments in the schools anymore. But what I'm saying is that we've lost influence. And how we've lost influence is the Christian mouth has become more and more closed, more and more closed. And less of God, and less of God. What's it going to take? I'll tell you what it's going to take. For Christian people, for the body of Christ to rise up early, set their alarm clocks early, get up a half an hour early, and seek Him early, and you'll find God, and things will change. You will change, things will change. America will change. Listen, it's more popular today to be popular than it is to be right. We've got 1,500 people trying to run for the Republican Party of the presidency of the United States. 1,500 people or something crazy like that. Folks, don't be dismayed. There's a lot of money to be made in popularity. There's a lot of money to be made in politics. There's a lot of money to be made in religion. And between you and me, it's all a bunch of junk. We need God to choose an axe head that will rise from the bottom of the river, that will rise up and be a symbol and a bright and shining armor of the faith of God and Jesus Christ. Can you say amen? We need holy leadership in our country once again. We need holy leadership in the church.
That's right.
We need holy leadership in our communities. Yeah. We don't need to brag about it. We need to sing about it. We need to pray for it. I love those who love me, and those who seek me early find me. Get up early and seek the Lord and you'll find Him. That's a process goal. That's a process goal. Hallelujah. So where am I going next with this? Oh yeah. John chapter 14. Let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap. I'll get to the faint not next week. Let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season ye shall reap. We shall reap. I believe this year is a year of reaping. John chapter 14, verse 21. He that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. Folks, this isn't talking about just being Christian. In fact, when I ask people now about other people, friends or family members or whoever, I don't ask them if they're a Christian. I ask them if they're a believer.
Oh, so is your husband, is he a believer? I don't ask her. So is your husband a Christian? The guy your daughter's dating, is he a Christian? I don't ask that. I say, is the guy your daughter's dating, is he a believer? He that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. And he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father. See, it's a process. And I will love him and will manifest myself to him. Those who love me, I love them. And those who seek me early shall find me. For without faith it is impossible to please God. For we must first believe that he is, and that he's a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. And you see, if you set a process goal, I'm going to exercise for 10 days in a row. The biology profit of that exercising for 10 days in a row can vary. And if we just isolate it to losing 5 pounds or an inch off the weight or waist or 10 pounds, and we don't hit that mark, it's human nature to become so discouraged and faithful that we quit. Because biology changes, especially the older we get. It takes, it's harder and it's longer to get it off. So my point being is, let's not try to isolate God with specific things, although we need specific things. But more than that, he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Let's let him choose how you're going to be blessed. Let God choose how it's going to happen. Amen. Let God in his sovereignty decide how your 10 days of continual prayer and seeking him, what he's going to reward you with. For when I come back, will I find faith on the earth. And when I come back, I will bring my reward with me. Hallelujah. Amen. Closing, I want to read commentary by Oswald Chambers concerning this love thing. Let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season we shall reap. For in due season, do you love me? Tend my sheep, Jesus said to the Lord. Listen as I read this. Jesus did not say to make converts to your way of thinking, but he said to look after his sheep, to see that they get nourished in the knowledge of him. We consider what we do in the way of Christian work as service. Yet Jesus Christ called service to be what we are to him, not what we do for him. What we are to him, not what we do for him. You see, I think we get that backwards. Discipleship is based solely on devotion to Jesus Christ, not on following after a particular belief or doctrine. If anyone come to me and does not hate, he went on to say, he cannot be my disciple. Luke chapter 14. In this verse, there is no argument and no pressure from Jesus to follow him. He is simply saying, in effect, if you want to be my disciple, you must be devoted solely to me. A person touched by the Spirit of God suddenly says, now I see who Jesus is. That is the source of devotion. Today we have substituted doctrinal belief for personal belief. And that is why so many people are devoted to causes and so few are devoted to Jesus Christ. People do not really want to be devoted to Jesus, but only to the cause that he started. You see, Jesus Christ is deeply offensive to the educated minds of today. To those who only want him to be their friend and who are willing to accept him in any other way. Our Lord's primary obedience was to the will of the Father, not to the needs of people. The saving of people was the natural outcome of his obedience to the Father. If I am devoted solely to the cause of humanity, I will soon be exhausted and come to the point where my love will waver and stumble. You see, that's a product goal. We get weary. We have to look at our lives and the things that we do in our everyday lives for other people. We have to look at it as doing it as unto the Lord. Folks, I have to remind myself every single day, Lord, I'm doing this even as unto you. For if even as you have done it unto the least of these, you have done it unto me. Hallelujah. Lord, I'm doing this as unto you. You will soon become exhausted and come to a point where my love will waver and stumble. But if I love Jesus Christ personally and passionately, if I love Jesus Christ personally and passionately, I can serve humanity even though people may treat me like a doormat. Let me just stop there and tell you, you know, it is no fun to be treated like a doormat. And it is no fun to get stepped on, especially by children. It's no fun to be bullied by somebody, to be treated like a doormat. No fun. There's no fun in that. But if I'm solely devoted to Jesus Christ and passionate about that relationship, then I can serve humanity. And in those moments when I'm treated like a doormat, I just look towards heaven and see the cross of Calvary. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. The secret of a disciple's life is devotion to Jesus Christ. I love those who love me, and those who seek me early will find me. And the characteristics of that life, in its seemingly insignificant and its meekness, yet it is like a grain of wheat, and I close with this. I love when he says this. And yet it is like a grain of wheat that falls into the ground and dies, it will spring up and change the entire landscape. It will raise up and it will change the entire landscape. That's a process goal. That's a process goal. And folks, so I encourage you as we close this morning to change the landscape of wherever you live. Impact that landscape. We can't change the world. We're not even going to pray for the world. Jesus said, I don't pray for the world. I pray for those, Father, to whom you have given me. We don't pray for the world. For the world knows him not, and the world knows you and I not, because we're not of the world. So what do we pray for? We pray for one another. We pray for our loved ones. We pray for our lineage. Yes, we pray for the United States of America. Oh, God, forgive us of our sins and raise up righteous leadership. Yes. Absolutely. But change the landscape of where you exist, where you live. For I believe when he says, let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season ye shall reap. And I believe this year is a season for reaping. Can you say amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah.